Well, very good to see you again, 15 years after we last met.
I have met quite a few people since then, but I do remember you. Was it convincing?
Kind of. Oh. It was almost there. There you
see,
go.
I thought I'd got better as an actress, not worse.
Anyway, so 15 years on, I've read various rumours that Gwyneth Paltrow was offered the part, Uma Thurman as well. Were you on the phone to James Cameron wanting the part or not?
You see, it's really funny because a lot of people have said, now, I heard that you really aggressively went after this role. And, you know, I didn't aggressively go after the role. I really wanted it. And what that meant was making sure that I was so prepared for those auditions that I put myself through dialect coaching to get my American accent as good as I possibly could.
Darling, surely you remember Mr. Dawson?
Wanted it, you know, you just kind of sit and almost pray, you know. I remember like writing letters to myself, you know, about staying motivated and positive thinking and all that stuff.
And acting alongside Leonardo DiCaprio, I've read you were goofing around on set, that it was fun, you became, you know, very good friends. I mean, what was that like? Did you sense that there was something kind of special there about, you know, your on-screen chemistry?
We got on very well right away. I really admired him as an actor. I mean, I remember saying to my girlfriends, oh my God, you're not going to believe it. I've been cast in this film, and this is the character, and this is the director, but guess who's playing opposite me? Oh my God, Leonardo DiCaprio. I mean, he was in Basketball Diaries and What's Eating Gilbert Grape, and everybody knew about this extraordinary guy. And we looked after each other.
I'm flying!
And people still now are fascinated by our friendship, absolutely fascinated by it, which is lovely, you know.
And your director, James Cameron, obviously many stories about his, you know, his dedication to his craft, to put it politely. I mean, you've said that you nearly drowned in some of the filming. I mean, what was it like working with him, a man so driven by his vision?
It was really, really tough. Jim Cameron didn't go around just yelling at people and hitting us. He was just a very demanding director of his actors and his crew because he wanted the best. So he never actually lost his temper for nothing, you know.
What is it about Titanic which still fascinates people 100 years after it sank? What is it about this event, do you think?
The tragedy itself, that just captivates people, and that it, you know, until very, very recently, there were still survivors alive. So that will always be the captivating backdrop. It moved people and really meant something. And I think that will probably always be the case with stories of that nature.